Hi, this is Andrian. It's not Andrea. It's not Andriana. It's not Adriana. Forgot my intro, but it's definitely not Adrian. And welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome to my channel. If this is going to be the first time that you're going to watch my video, I'm drunk tonight, but I'm not alcoholic. I'm just drunk. After a long time, I was able to party. I was able to go out and really like party and I kind of drunk a lot, and yeah, I feel I'm gonna regret this when I wake up. Four in the morning, actually, and I've just got home. Okay, enough with the whatever. But if you guys remember, if you follow me on my social media, I posted something on YouTube. I also posted something on Instagram. I asked you guys to send me some questions, any question under the sun or anything you want to say to me. I thought it would be fun that I'm gonna answer this when I'm drunk. I'm sorry if I was not able to answer that on, you know, within 24 hours, but I'm going to answer it now that I'm drunk. I think it would be fun because I am too honest when I'm drunk. I talk a lot when I'm drunk. So, okay. Let's start. Okay, this is probably gonna take time, but hope you guys get to watch the video from the beginning to the end. Okay, let's start answering the question. First question is from Abdul Ahad. Abdul underscore Ahad. He says, how are you? Well, that's a very, like, it's a general question, but it's really kind of like hard to answer. But in general, I'm doing great. Yeah, there are just, you know, you always, people have struggles in life, but in general, I think I'm doing great. Yeah, I'm so bad at this. Second question is from Elias19SH or Elias19, okay, whatever. Will you come back to Europe? Definitely, I'll definitely come back to Europe. It's quite an experience. It was quite an experience, but Europe is so beautiful. It's so dreamy. Oh, I love Paris. It's so beautiful. It was my first time. But yeah, I would love to see more of Europe. Definitely. I'm coming back, hopefully next year. And from Mr. Alex Rivas. Goals 2022. You're so cute and sexy. Thank you, Mr. Alex Rivas. My goals for 2022 is, of course, to, oh my gosh. Honestly, I know I haven't been filming on YouTube, but I always say this. I want to keep doing YouTube videos my English has expired already. One of my goals in 2022 is to keep making videos. I want to be active more on YouTube because I have been thinking to like rebuild my community here on YouTube, and I know you guys have been asking me and you've been sending me messages telling me that you guys have been missing me here, and I kind of have a busy life, you know, some things that I have to sort out my personal life. So I'll definitely be active on YouTube on 2022. Of course, be healthy. Gosh, I cannot think straight anymore. I'm like, this is not going well. Okay, I'll promise to answer the remaining questions properly. From JSDEdge10 or 10. He says, "Will you be my wife?" Well, for you to be my husband, you need to propose to me first. You need to kneel down and yeah. Well, but I don't know, of course, I don't know. It takes a lot of work. From Kelly _ Kasul, how many languages do you speak? I basically speak two languages. My native language, which is Filipino or Tagalog, and English. Yeah, it's from the Rabbi Maroon. He said, if there was ever a chance to take you out, and would you go out with me? I would love to. I definitely would love to go out. And I love to go out and just and eat. Actually, I have a confession. There was a time that I installed Tinder, because I crave for good conversation and free food. Yeah, definitely. I'm sorry, it's really embarrassing. I use Tinder to get fancy dinner and food. Yeah, but, well, those were the days, but not anymore. I'm too old for that. Sorry, guys, I'm like so drunk. I am so drunk. I thought I can do this, but I don't think I can. I don't think I'm going to upload this on YouTube because it's going to be embarrassing. If I edit this video, I would be just, gosh, I would be just embarrassing myself, but just seeing myself on the video drunk. Sorry. Okay, I'll keep going just in case I decide to upload this video. From R.Baker2, what is your height? I am 5'7", and I think that is 165 centimeters. Yeah, roughly. Yeah. Next question is from Peter Ward 859, and he asks, what is your favorite country to visit? My favorite country to visit, I think, would be France. Yeah, France. And well, it was my first time coming to Europe, and it's a whole different place. It's a different culture. So I think it's my favorite. It's my most favorite now. Before I come to Europe, I think my most favorite country to visit was Bali, Indonesia. It was so beautiful. I wish this pandemic ends soon so that we can travel again and see beautiful places. I miss traveling a lot, like a lot, a lot. From Sheila Tony, what is your favorite food? I think I don't have a specific favorite. I love spicy food. Lately, I have been having a sort of addiction to kimchi, the Korean, I don't know, it's an appetizer. I love it. I eat kimchi with every food I eat. Yeah, I don't know, I just have addiction to that. But yeah, spicy food, definitely. Okay, next question is from Jerd. M4N is how you read that. Not a question. Just want to say you look beautiful. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Not right now. I feel like I look wasted. I don't know what this video would look like when I upload it. Oh my god, the roosters are... Can you hear the roosters, guys? It's almost 5 in the morning and I'm like still awake. And I still need to remove my makeup, and I still need to wash my face. I still need to shower. Yeah, Yeah, definitely. I live in a countryside, you guys, so you can always hear the roosters. Don't worry, guys. Once I get my mic with noise canceling, definitely, all you would hear is my voice. We can do ASMR with my voice, but not with chickens, not with roosters, hopefully. Another question from Shreyansh Kamlesh. He said, can we chat? I usually don't check message requests. I rarely, rarely check message requests. If you guys been sending me messages, I might not be able to read it. I just check it once in a while, but I usually don't reply to it. But you know, when you posted a comment on any of my photos, or you commented, I always try to reply, or I always like or heart your comments, and I appreciate it. I appreciate all your comments and your likes, honestly. Demetrius Collis, how can you be so beautiful? Oh, that's a compliment. Thank you so much. I think the secret to feeling and looking beautiful is to really, really be happy with yourself, actually, to feel confident, to, if you look after yourself, if you pay attention to yourself, like self-care, skincare, whatever you can have, it will radiate from the inside, and people would notice that. And thank you so much. Next question from Greg Bishop. How can I meet you? I don't know. At the moment, the pandemic is really, really crazy with the new Omicron variant. More countries are heightened their restrictions again, which is not a little, but actually so sad, But yeah, we'll see about that. A question from Benzia the Youssef. Is all right. Where are you from? I'm from the Philippines. I'm from the Philippines. I'm from Manila. Manila, Philippines. Yeah, it's okay. It's crowded. Ooh. Hussein from Hussein J. Spin Daddy. How porn helps your brain? How porn helping your brain? I think there was a time I commented on a 9gag post, and it was about Billie Eilish saying that it has affected her brain negatively because of porn. And I commented, I said, but porn helped my brain development. And I think he took it seriously. Yeah, but how porn helps my brain to develop? I think it widens my imagination and makes me see things in a way that I don't see myself doing. Okay, are we talking about porn right now? Oh my gosh, I'm gonna be banned on YouTube. But yeah. But honestly, I was just kidding. I was just kidding on that comment. Don't take it seriously. There's another question from Austin Peach. Would you ever be a porn star? Oh my gosh, where are these questions coming from? I'll think about that. But if ever, there's nothing wrong with being a porn star. There's nothing wrong about sex work. There's nothing wrong about it. Sex work is work. Porn stars are professionals, and people from OnlyFans, they are definitely earning a lot. And yeah. And if ever, yeah, why not? I think I'm gonna be a famous porn star. Right, Daddy? Sorry, that's cringy. Those questions are crazy. Thank you guys for asking me the questions. I'm sorry if I haven't answered them properly. I'm too drunk. I feel dehydrated. I feel like my throat is really dry. I need something in my throat right now. But yeah. Oh my gosh. Have we forgotten questions? Oh my god, there are other questions. Oh my god, there are other questions. Another question would be from Chris Nicolix. Is that how you read it? I'm sorry. Excuse me, why are you so cute? Oh, thank you. Thank you, find me. Thank you if you find me cute. This one is definitely straightforward. This question is so straightforward. He says, let's make a date, have sex. What do you think? I don't think so. I don't have sex on a first date. Maybe on a third. I'm just kidding. Oh my gosh, guys, I cannot read your usernames. I'm just gonna post it. The question is, how did you get so nice, buddy? Was it hormone or surgery? Thank you, first of all. Well, of course, I take hormones. It's been a decade now that I've been on my transition, and I'm really, really happy with all the results that I have gotten. The only surgery I had is my breast, definitely, but nothing else, that's all. So probably it's hormones and of course surgery with my breast, and I made sure I got the perfect size, but for me at least. We don't want to have super big boobs. Next question is from Mr. Eham 11. Hello Andrea, are transgender women sweet, polite, soft-spoken, and amazing to date? That's a general question. I think it always depends with the transgender woman. Not necessarily transgender women, but women, you know? It depends. It depends on a woman or what type of woman you're looking for, definitely. But always remember, you know, when it comes to dating, if you want to date someone polite, someone sweet, someone soft-spoken and amazing, you always attract what you project. You know, if you want to attract someone amazing, definitely you will. Yeah. So it's really hard to answer because not all trans women are sweet, or some of them are strong. Some of them are not soft-spoken, and some of them are maybe not too polite, but very straightforward. And yeah, I cannot speak for other trans women, but I think I think it depends. From Miss Angie underscore 1970, her question is, what is the most important thing on your bucket list? I think the most important thing on my bucket list would be migrating to Europe, maybe. There are two things on my bucket list. It's either migrating to Europe or pursuing my studies in Europe, maybe, or in the US or in Canada. Definitely. I dream to migrate and live somewhere in those countries. Yeah. Where I would feel liberated, I would feel a lot respected, I would be I wouldn't lie about myself being a transgender woman, but I think I would be stealth. I would be more passable being in those countries than, you know, live and die in the Philippines, which I definitely don't want that to happen. Next question would be global travel plans. I think, as I have mentioned, I want to travel back to Europe and then to US, to Canada. Oh gosh, I think those are my next global travel plans, but hopefully the pandemic gets better. Hopefully, you know, we have come to a point where we have contained it, and everyone gets vaccinated, or everyone gets immune to it, so we can go back and do the normal things we used to do. I kind of miss that. From Christopher Rivas. You seem happier lately. Any reason to think? I think I'm thankful for the love of family, you know, no matter what happens, pandemic, anything, family has been there for me. We've been there for each other, whatever happens. And for the gift of health, for the gift of love, for the gift of happiness. Yeah. And of course, you guys, I know that I haven't been active, but, and you have been waiting for me to upload content, and I promise that I'm gonna be active 2022. I promise, definitely promise this time. Another question is, how is your transition started? That's from Chris_009. I think I started my transition when I started working and earning money back in 2009 or 2010. I always felt like I'm in the wrong body, and I think I would really have to correct that. I didn't like the body I had before, and I had to correct that, and that's how it started my transition. It's courage. It's definitely the dysphoria that pushed me to the transition. Yeah. And there you have it, guys. Thank you very much for asking me the questions. I don't know, it might seem boring, but just too drunk right now. I don't know what to say. I cannot talk properly. I think it's because, you know, under the influence. I cannot feel my face. I cannot feel my lips. I feel numb. You know what I miss about being drunk is making love while you're drunk and you're like super dizzy and you're in bed. Oh my gosh. I have young audience, so let's not go that way. I love you guys. Thank you so much. I'm filming this on Christmas Day. Merry Christmas. Oh my god. I went partying because it's Christmas. Oh my gosh, I totally forgot. Merry Christmas, guys. Merry Christmas. I love you. I hope you guys are having a great time with your family. I know some of you guys maybe are not spending Christmas with loved ones. Maybe you may have lost them because of the pandemic, or maybe you're struggling this year, but that's okay. I know somewhere along the way you're gonna get through all of that. And I love you guys. Thank you. Please don't forget to subscribe, and if you like this video, hit thumbs up. And if you have anything to say, I don't care what it is, it could be a hate comment or it could be anything, please put it in the comment below. Let's talk about it. Let's have a conversation on the comment box. I love you. I definitely need to remove my makeup now. And I'm sleepy. I'm dizzy. I love you. Mwah.